Hi, I'm Munish Johar, and you're watching me on Rolling Frames Entertainment. So today I'm going to talk to you about why a hobby or a passion is important while maintaining a work-life balance. I actually started my career almost 2 decades ago. And initially, you know, when you start out professionally, your only goal in life is to work and make it big. And I used to actually spend my entire day in office. You know, when I was doing a job, if my boss would call me at 2 in the morning, I would report for work at 2 in the morning. And then eventually when I started my own company, you know, that same work ethic kind of followed me. I would be the first one in office and I would be the last one to leave. I would actually take pride in that you know what, I'm first in, last out. But eventually, somewhere down the line, you know, all this starts getting to you. You know, you start getting very stressed. You can see all the white hair I carry right now. I look old, but I'm not that old. But, you know, it starts getting to you. All the stress, the pressure, it kills you basically. So somewhere along the line, you know what, you want to strike a balance. And I thought maybe, you know what, maybe I should pursue a hobby. And I have always been passionate about things that I've been doing. When I started out, I listened to a lot of music, and that was my first hobby. I still listen to music. You know, for all said and done, I was one of those guys who listened to heavy metal, and I still listen to heavy metal. I don't look like a metalhead, but I love my heavy metal music. I still listen to it all day. I then actually kind of progressed to keeping fish, and I still maintain 5 aquariums. I have one in office as well. And you know, that gives me a very soothing kind of thing, watching the fish at night. When I get stressed, I switch off all the lights and just see my aquarium for an hour. 10-15 minutes helps me out. A few years back, probably around 5 years back, I started seriously pursuing another hobby called bird watching. You know, I found a group of like-minded people in Chandigarh. It's called the Chandigarh Bird Club. And with them, I actually started going on weekly trips and I started picking up bird watching, and then I actually progressed to bird photography. And this really kind of helped me break the monotony, you know, of my daily drudgery, you know, working in office. My time of bird watching is the time where I don't touch my phone, and I'm a guy who looks at his phone perpetually. You know, even if I get up at 2 in the morning, 3 in the morning, the first thing I do is I look at my phone. But when I'm bird watching, I never look at my phone. You know, it came to me subconsciously, but I gradually realized that when I'm out bird watching or doing bird photography, I don't look at my phone. It could be for 2 hours, 3 hours, and you know, it's bliss. You know, it helps break the stress. And I really enjoyed that hobby. I've been pursuing that still on and off. So like I said, you know, an entrepreneur's life is full of ups and downs. It's like riding a roller coaster basically. You know, you have your highs, you have your lows, and eventually, you know, you build up stress, and with stress comes weight. So around 2015, you know, I started putting on a lot of weight. So typical thing, you know, I thought, how do I lose this weight? So I used to run I used to play lawn tennis as a child, and they used to make us run around in CLT, Chandigarh Lawn Tennis Association. We used to run these 15-20 rounds around the stadium. So, you know, the first impulse that came to me was, let me try running. You know, I can try running at the lake. Throughout my life, I was what you would call a monthly kind of runner. Once in 2 months, I would go to the lake and I would run a little bit and feel very good about it that I've run. But around 2015, in mid-2015, I decided to kind of take, you know, run my first half marathon. So I started practicing for that. From June onwards, I remember I'd gone for my summer vacation with my family. I come back and I started doing this running thing a little bit more seriously. Started going to the lake, and I remember when I started, initially I couldn't run anything. I could hardly run for 200-300 meters and I would stop. But gradually I started building on that, kind of, you know, kept pushing myself a little bit, need to do it. Somewhere along the line, somebody told me there's this thing called Airtel Delhi Half Marathon, which happens in November. And I remember I signed up for it, and it was 21 kilometers. You know, it's a huge distance for a guy who's not run 2 kilometers also. And I kept pushing myself like a slow pitch. And eventually I ran my first half marathon in November 2015. And you know, that running bug kind of bit me around then. I started taking it a little bit more seriously. I signed up for a few more events, kind of lost interest somewhere in between. And but I kept on, I kept at it, like, you know, 2-3 times a week I would go out and run. So all of 2016 kind of passed like that. I went back and ran the Airtel Delhi half marathon again. In 2017, I started taking running a bit more seriously. I still remember there was this 100 days of running challenge that happens in the summers. The goal of the challenge is that you actually have to run a minimum of 2 kilometers every day for 100 days non-stop. And this started somewhere around 28th or 29th of April of 2017. And I signed up for the challenge, and then my elder daughter says, you know what, Dad, I'll also run with you. So she also signed up for it. And you know, during those, and this is the summer, okay, you know, summer time. And in summers, we were also going for a vacation to the US. And I still remember on 2 days, we actually ran at the airport also. You know, people were looking at us, but we were running in where we had checked in. We were running over there also so as not to lose a day, basically, and make sure we run our minimum 2 kilometers every day. So once the challenge ended, I kind of thoroughly enjoyed it, and I never stopped running after that. So I still continue running a minimum of, now it's 3 kilometers every day. But since that day till today, I've been running every day, and I've taken running a bit more seriously, if you might like the term for it. Running works very well for me personally. The biggest takeaways for me here are, one, it helps me de-stress. There is, you know, you get out in the morning, you go out for a run, whatever happened the previous day, positive, negative, it's all gone away. Because as soon as you go out for a run, your mind is fresh, you come back and you get your own runner's high, like they say, you know, and you like to start your day in that positive note. It gives you a kick. It's such a positive thing, you know, you come to office fresh, energized, you want to, regardless of whatever might have happened the previous day. It gives you that positivity. So that works very, very well for me. Running's also taught me one more thing, you know, that you will have lots of ups and downs in life. And running kind of helps you neutralize that, balance that. Because, you know, especially long distance running, you face a lot of problems while you're doing that. You know, you go through a lot of ups, downs, mood swings. Yes, no, should I do this? Shouldn't I do this? But that kind of, at the end, it all balances out and you say, wow, I'm glad I did this. So that's a big positive thing, and that's really worked for me at work also, you know, helps me. I'm one of those kind of guys, I might say, I have a very short attention span. You know, I will take one task, I'll start doing it, then I'd like to move to the next one. I could never focus. But now running has helped me build that focus. So, you know, although it eats into my time in the mornings, but when I come into office, even if I have 3 hours, those 3 hours are pure focused work. I actually know how to segregate my work, how to prioritize, how to build it. In a lesser amount of time, actually, I am more productive now. So earlier, like I said, I used to sit for 12 hours in office. But now I can probably do the same stuff in 6 hours. So that has really helped me a lot, you know, build focus, kind of build goals, targets. That has been very, very helpful for me.